Hello, friends. Welcome to That's What She Said, June?
June.
It's our June episode. I'm lost in time because I've been locked at home for over a year, so I don't know what day it is anymore.
Nice.
How's everybody?
Good. Yeah. To see you all.
Yes.
You too. Hey, we just saw each other for the first time in over a year.
I know.
Oh, I did. Wasn't that fun? Oh my goodness.
It was so much fun. Martha's garden is like a magical wonderland.
It's like entering the secret garden.
I haven't laughed so long, so hard for such a long time.
I know. It was so necessary. Yes. It was a lot of fun. And I'm really glad that we got to do that. That was really cool.
That was so fun. And to be able to give you all a hug in person was
it's heaven.
It was just perfect. Nice. Yeah.
It was really nice. And, you know, we also got to get some nice herbs and stuff from Martha's garden, too. I got some lavender. It's all over the place. My house.
Oh, I'm glad.
I stole some mint and I planted it and gave it a good watering. So we'll see if it.
It'll come up. It grows like crazy.
Yeah, it looks a little anemic at the moment, but I think it'll be fine.
We'll get together.
Yeah. But
did you take any plants, Rusty?
No, I didn't.
You didn't? no plants? All right. Well, maybe next time.
We'll definitely do that again.
And I think that was the last nice night we're going to have out in the garden for a while, because the heat and the humidity are coming in. And it's not fun out there when it's like that. So,
but it was nice with no bugs.
It was perfect. It was perfect.
Were great.
Yeah.
Bugs all over me. Mosquitoes.
Me too. Although I did get bitten. Somebody bit.
Did you?
Yeah.
I didn't. I don't know. They must have gotten you, because I'm usually the one that gets bitten and I didn't get it.
I got a bite. I think you might be able to see it. I got a bite right there.
I'm going to get in closer to see. I see it now that you pointed it out.
I'm sorry about that.
Right there.
So you mind? It's on my knee. I could show you, but I don't really feel like lifting up my knee to the screen.
Sorry.
It was great. I'm so glad that we did that.
It could have been Thursday. It could have been in my backyard on Friday. I pulled out a massive ivy growth next to my garage on Friday that needed to go. And so I fought with ivy and I learned all about barberry bushes, because there's a barberry bush growing. So as I'm picking up
with the sticky things in them that they stick
It has straight up thorns on it. And I'm wearing gloves and it's going through the gloves and poking me. And, you know, this barberry bush, as it drops branches, the little twigs and stuff all have these inch long thorns on them. So I'm grabbing the ivy and I'm grabbing shed barberry branches. So I'm grabbing it. I'm like, And so now I'm ripping out this ivy and I'm getting thorns in my hands and I am screaming obscenities at the top of my lungs. So I feel so bad for my neighbors, because I'm like, mother. So finally I learned that I had to brush everything away, grab the ivy stem and just start ripping. But I'm fighting with, I'm fighting with the ivy, I'm fighting with barberry, I'm fighting with ant colonies that I'm finding. So I'm sure bugs were biting me too, but it was an eventful Friday. But now there's no more ivy.
No more ivy, you won. Nicole, I can't help but notice there's a new visitor behind you up on your bed there.
Do you see him?
I see that's a new addition to the family, right? Oops. Oh, he came to visit.
That is Remy. He's our brand new weaver. I went to the ARL yesterday, the Berks ARL, by the way. By the time everyone sees this show, the adoption event will be over, but we decided to pick him up on Friday. I get there and I find out there's an adoption event. So our adoption fees were waived. They were sponsored by Reading Railroad.
Nice.
So, so thank you, Reading Railroad, for that, for our new little family member. We still made a generous donation because we had planned to anyway, but He's 4 months old, and he.
Can you grab him, or is he gone?
He's right there. Hold on, let me see.
I want to see his face.
Gilla, what's your kitten's name?
This is Rizzo, and he's a little old man. He's gonna be 13 soon.
Really?
Yeah. There's Remy.
Hi, David.
There's Remy.
Remy, he is so cute.
He has such a baby face.
I know.
Right? Yeah, he does.
So sweet. So the girl who was helping me told me that his litter. Okay, hold on, buddy. I'll help you in a little bit. The lady helping me said that his litter, which was about 5 kittens, they came from a hoarding situation, a pet hoarding situation. So, yeah, so he's going to have a much better life now. But, yeah, we've got him in our guest room, you know, because you want to introduce him slowly. So he's there right now, and David's hanging out with me. So, but, yeah, we love him.
He's on my arm right now.
Yeah, hi, kitty.
You just saw him gnawing on my shirt here. This is Rizzo. He's a bad boy. He's only pretending to be sweet right now.
Actually, Truman.
He is a good boy.
Let's see if I can get my dog, Truman.
Truman. Hey. I know Truman's a love bug. Where's your animals, Rusty? Your cats don't really creep around.
I know. Yeah. They're normally walking around. Margo's sitting here, kind of. Well, she's right in front of the fan, so I guess she's.
He's chilling. Oh,
yeah,
some air.
That's the place to be, though.
The fan. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of up. I'm upstairs, and it's kind of warm here, so.
They're not a fan.
Yeah.
My mom Truman, has a long hair cat.
Truman goes around. Truman looks for the air vents when he can. He just goes from one right. air conditioning vent to another when he's really.
Truman has a lot of long hair, so I imagine that he gets hot fast.
Yeah.
He's such a good boy, though. He was nice.
He's a good boy. He was a little mad at me because I didn't let him stay out with the girl.
That's my fault.
He really wanted to stay. He just loves.
Next time I'll be friendly to him. I promise.
My favorite part, he comes around and, you know, he's a little face of his is so sweet. Aww. And then you're like, okay, Truman, time to go inside. And he just lays down. He just sits down. And he's like, well, if you can move me, then I'll leave. But until then, I'm here.
Yeah, he didn't want to go in. He was cute.
Yeah, he's very much of a conniving, manipulative puppy. I just talked to my son this afternoon. He lives in Portland, and I saw it was 112 there. But I gave him a call, and he said, no, it was 102. He said, and most of them, they don't have air conditioning, but they have units in their house now. He said, I've just got all the window shades down, and he said, it's really not too bad. But he has a dog, and he said she just hates going out in this weather. She just lies in the slates in front of the hearth in the front of their fireplace to keep up cool. He said, yeah, she doesn't have any desire to go outside.
It probably burns feet.
Yeah, he said it's really hot.
That's awful.
Yeah.
Don't envy them.
And as I said, those people are so not used to it out there. They don't have air conditioning normally in their houses.
Yeah.
So it's yeah.
He's in Oregon, right?
Well, excuse me.
He's in Oregon, or Maine?
Yeah, yeah, in Oregon. No, in Oregon.
It's not usually hot there.
Yeah.
Yeah, I have family in Washington State, and central air is not. Really common in those houses at all.
No.
Really?
That hot.
Yeah.
I don't understand. You know, I've not had air conditioning once in my life, and I'll never, ever do it again. That's a deal breaker for me going forward. If there's no air, I cannot.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. There's not central air. I ain't there.
You're a poet and you didn't even know it. Thanks for visiting, Rizzo. My arms are going numb. We've got a lot of topics on our list here. We've got a lot of things to discuss. Like the hot topic right now, there's a hot topic with Miss Britney Spears going on. You know, it's been going on for a while, this Free Britney movement.
Yeah, and hashtag Free Britney.
Yeah, and in case, you know, anyone didn't read it, she gave a 30-minute deposition in court about her conservatorship, about how she's being forced to be on birth control, and they're taking all her money and forcing her to go to rehabs and all kinds of terrible things. It's very sad, actually. I don't know if anybody else listened to it. Did anyone listen to it?
I didn't listen to the whole deposition, but I read parts of it, and it's really it makes me feel terrible because she's my age. I mean, she's almost 40. And yeah, it's very sad. Like I think about the trajectory of my life and her life, and you know, and I realized that in this whole time, you know, she was famous, I'm not, but I had choice. I had agency over my body. I had the ability to marry who I wanted. And if what she says is true, which, you know, I feel like it is, yeah, then she hasn't had any of that. She hasn't, I mean, for them to have said, like for her father to have said, you're not allowed to have any more kids, you're getting an IUD. So he made a doctor put something in her body and she didn't want it there. Like that is the sheer definition of agency over body.
I honestly didn't, I have to say I'm not a Britney Spears fan. She's just a little bit younger than most of the artists that I follow. And so I really didn't know too much about her. I remember reading about it when she had her flame out. And
yeah,
but that was quite a while ago. Was it 2014 or something?
Yeah, it was over 10.
And she was very young. And it seems to me that I can't believe that what is happening to her is even legal. I can't imagine conservatorship that she has been forced to perform, and she's been performing all this time and making money, which she doesn't really get to touch except what is given to her. She's apparently allowed to go to Hawaii once a year for a vacation. But to have an IUD inserted and then that she's forced to use it, that just seems to me to be against everything that women have been marching for in all these years. I'm appalled. And yet I just read that they said, well, this is not an unusual conservatorship. Now I would think a conservator would be put together for someone who was incapable of thinking logically or taking care of themselves. She obviously is pretty sharp because she's performing in Las Vegas regularly. I just really, really, as I said, I really didn't pay too much attention to Britney Spears until I heard about this week. And now I'm appalled. I am really angry that any woman would be put through that.
Yeah.
You know, I can say limiting her income, limiting what access she can have to her money, but she's 39 years old and some man is telling her that she has to have an IUD in her body that she doesn't want and can't have it removed.
Mm-hmm. And there's been, I mean, I can't say that I've followed it very closely because I'm not a huge Britney Spears fan, but I like her stuff.
I just put play and let it go.
Yeah, so. Exactly. And I've always liked her. And, you know, I mean, we're contemporaries, we're the same age. So I remember following her and seeing like, yeah, her shaving her head and, you know, with Kevin Federline having her two kids and stuff like that. And you're like, okay, she's, you know, she's acting out. Well, then it makes a lot of sense. That's why she's acting out, because she's being constricted so much by people who do not have her best interest in mind. So that was her way of, you know, trying to, I don't know,
control that.
You heard. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Rusty, you were going to say something. What were you going to say about this?
I don't know. I lost it.
Great.
Just, it's pretty amazing that someone her age could be controlled like that.
Yeah. Right.
Like Martha said, like, how could this even happen? How is it legal?
That's like still being grounded for something you did back when you were a teenager, like as an adult, you know? Like you can't, you're not allowed to make mistakes and have moments and then grow out of it.
Yeah,
she was allowed to get out of what she was in trouble for in the first place.
She has two teenage boys, and it sounds like she's raising them. Is that, am I correct in that? It sounds like they're with her.
I think so. Yeah, I think they live with her in Las Vegas. I don't know if they have any visitation with their father.
But apparently she's capable of raising children.
She did say that the boys went to Louisiana. So I think that they do split custody.
Okay.
Kevin Federline's in Louisiana right now.
I think
didn't she start performing when she was really, really young?
She was on Mickey Mouse.
So she was making money for her family when she was quite young.
Yep.
And I mean, she was really the cash cow of the family, and they just,
yep.
No wonder. I mean, all that fame and all that publicity as a teenager very often leads to people in their early 20s having emotional problems until they get themselves together. And she's obviously gotten herself together and is still making money for her family, which it's just incredibly strange to me that that's allowed.
Sometimes I think it's hard for parents to let their children who have been so lucrative for them go off and be lucrative.
Oh, sure.
But yeah, they did a reboot of Mickey Mouse Clubhouse. And
I used to watch that in the 90s.
Oh,
that's,
I loved
right.
it. And yeah. it had Christina Aguilera, Britney Spears, Justin Timberlake, Ryan Gosling, Carrie Russell, a couple more people, but a lot of people who then became very well-known public figures. So
that's sad. I really just hope that the judges listen to what she had to say, because she was very well spoken. I mean, she was clearly nervous. She was like motor mouthing and super fast, and the judge was like, you have to slow down, my court reporter's trying to like they told her repeatedly, like, you have to speak slower. She's like, I'm sorry, I'm just really nervous, and I just really want to get, like, she would catch herself all the time that she was, you know, racing through this, but she was very well spoken. She really had, like, she had her thoughts on paper, and she,
good for her.
Yeah, like, yeah. She got her point across to the point where her ex-boyfriend was like, you know, what's happening to her is not right. Like, whatever our past is, we should definitely be standing behind her.
Oh, that's wonderful. That,
yeah,
like, she got that support. Yeah, my final thought is, you know, as a woman the same age as me, so someone who's my contemporary, my heart goes out to her, and I hope that she finds some peace and some happiness. So I'm rooting for her. I really am.
I think we all feel, I mean, I'm twice her age, and I'm certainly rooting for her, and I'm really going to be following to see what happens to it. But I think that's just disgraceful, what's happening to her.
Yeah.
I agree. I hope she gets married and have babies and do everything she wants to.
Agreed.
Just live a normal life without control.
Yeah. Leave Britney alone.
Britney. Yeah. And what's great is that, like, you know, for years she was denying everything and saying that, you know, there's nothing going on, you know, this Free Britney thing, there's no reason for this. And now she's like, okay, I was lying. You know, there was definitely an issue. So that's cool that she fessed up to lying and
she
was covering everything up. So good for her. We are proud of you, Britney. Now, we were together just the other day, and it's been over a year. So, you know, COVID is not gone at all, but it's simmering, and, you know, with vaccinations, everything. Now there's this new strain of things coming along.
The Delta variant.
Yeah. What do we think about that? Are we as equally fearful?
Yeah.
What do you think, Rusty?
I'm fearful. I mean, because is there a vaccine for this one yet?
No, I mean, it's not a specific vaccine for it, because it's a new variant. I forget the origin of it, but yeah, it's wreaking some havoc. Fauci was a little nervous about it.
Yeah.
So
I guess the Pfizer vaccine and the Moderna are supposed to be 80%, they think, effective against it. Mm-hmm. That's, you know, that makes me wonder, am I going to be in that 20%?
Nothing to worry about, yeah.
Aren't you? I mean, I was so scared when COVID started a year and a half ago. I was just so sure that I was going to get it and die. And because of my age and, you know, other health problems that I've had in the past, I really was sure. And now we're at this point, we're feeling, it was so good to see all of you in person again and realizing what an amazing friendship we have. By the way, I don't think our viewers realize what really good friends we are.
Yes.
But it scares me because I think this variant, and the thing about it is that it could morph into another variant. It could morph into the epsilon or whatever the next Greek letter is in line. it can morph at any time. And that's frightening because it's apparently appearing in different parts of the country and they have no idea why. So scary.
Young people hard, which is something that the other virus wasn't as deadly, I guess, or as serious. So here I am.
Yeah, have you seen anything about this coming through? Like what information have you gotten?
None. I don't know anything about this.
Well, not in our area yet, but it is something. Basically, just keep your eye, just follow. We get news reports at the agency with being the contact tracers and the case tracers, but I don't know enough about it yet. Mm-hmm. But I do urge anybody who hasn't gotten vaccinated to do it. It just is crazy if you don't.
Yeah, at this point, there's literally no argument that you should logically have to not get this thing. And especially with this new variant out, and what they're finding is that the majority of people who are contracting COVID at this point are unvaccinated. So go get the vaccine.
And younger people too.
And younger people. Yeah,
seems to be really striking much younger people.
That scares me for my kids, you know?
Yeah.
They're too little to be vaccinated.
Yeah, go get the vaccine, if for nothing else than to protect, you know, people's children that are nervous about it. Because
Nicole, let me ask you: your kids wear masks? Like, do you put masks on your kids when you go out and stuff? Do you still wear them?
I have been on and off. Like, if I go into the grocery store and there aren't many people there, I won't wear it. But if I'm going into a restaurant or a food place, like if I'm picking up food, if it's a smaller space, if there's a lot of people. And then my other rule is if I see the people who are working there wearing masks, out of respect and solidarity, I wear my mask too. But if I'm outside in a public place, I'm not wearing it. I'm just in this weird place where I'm just not sure. Like, I don't feel 100% safe. I'm vaccinated. I have been. I don't know how safe I feel not wearing it. Like, I feel like there's no reason to not wear it. Like, you know, it's not going to harm me if I do wear it. Hold on. My cat is
still wearing
things.
Even at, you know, I think for a while, I'm probably just going to wear it anyway. Just because.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd feel comfortable going someplace without a mask now.
But I agree.
I just feel it's safer. And then I think the people behind my mask and they don't know that I'm or something. So I kind of spoiled with that.
I thought it was interesting. I watched the Derek Chauvin sentencing yesterday just by chance. I, you know, was not even aware that it was going to happen, and I got a flash on my phone and I wasn't doing anything, so I turned it on. I was really I guess surprised to see that everybody, including Derek Chauvin, was wearing a mask. And that a judge was wearing a mask when he spoke. He took it off. They had three witnesses who spoke for the prosecution before the sentencing was read. And they were all wearing masks until they spoke, and they took them off. And then when they were finished, they put them back on. As I said, he was wearing a mask, which I really didn't care about, but it's like, but it was, I don't know why, that just really surprised me to see them all, you know, the cops, the court guards, they were all wearing masks.
There's still a lot of government buildings, I think, still have all of their mask mandates in place. And I've gotten into the habit of, like, I keep one on me always. And if I'm going into a building, I look for the sign that says, if you're vaccinated, you can choose, or everyone must wear a mask. And then I follow it to the letter. Because I'm entering your place of business, so
yeah, you make the rules.
Yeah, I'm going to follow your rules. That's kind of how it should be.
And I just read, I read or heard today, I think Bruce Springsteen's Broadway review either started last night or it starts on Monday. So it's the first Broadway show that has come back, and you have to show proof of vaccination to get in.
Oh wow.
Yeah, we were told, it was suggested to us not to laminate the original card in case you needed to, you know, get a booster on that. But so I made copies of mine and Jesse's and laminated them, and we each have them in our wallets so that
You can take a picture of it and put it on your phone too.
Yeah.
That's what this people have been recommending.
With your phone, I have it's easy enough for me just to have a laminated one
in
my purse, so that's what I'm doing. And I have no problem if someone's like, in order to enter this business we need proof of vaccination, I will probably be like,
come on.
Well, Jesse was telling me, like, his work is super serious. He had to upload his vaccination to prove vaccination. I don't know if they're requiring it, but he was happy to show it. And then there's a survey he has to fill out every day, you know, about symptoms and contact. Yeah. And
all of that.
Yeah, we stopped.
And he has to fill it out if he's going to come in.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Oh, COVID.
Allergies. I was holding the cat.
I was going to say, it sounds like hay fever.
It is. But that app, you know, I didn't ever get to go back to work, but I had that same app on my phone, that wellness app, that if I had gone into the building, I would have had to do that same survey and
every single day.
My temperature taken every day. And
Rusty, you've been working to set up appointments at the county vaccination center, and I know they're about to close, but are people going for their second shots? Are you having trouble getting people in for their second shots?
It's crazy. There's so many people just going for the two shot regimen, but not going back for their second shot.
I just don't understand that.
And it makes no sense. But I do have a lot more people calling in trying to make appointments to get J&J because it is only one shot.
Okay.
More convenient. So, they don't want to go back for the second one, or they can't, or
they're not going back.
It could be any number of reasons, I guess. Like, I mean, some people, I'm sure, is out of sheer laziness, but I think a lot of people have trouble getting it off work or having a ride or something.
Yeah.
No, that doesn't fly because
Rusty's like, nope.
They have hours, and it's not just a vaccination center, it's like pretty much any drugstore you can go to. You can walk, you can go to Walmart and get it done, you can go to a Giant and get it done.
They're like begging you to come in and take these vaccines.
Actually, we're
offering free rides until this coming till 4th of July. But now it's funny because we were told about it, but you have to have the app on your phone. So If people called, like, hey, Oop is doing it. Oh, could you set that up for me? No, I can't. You have to do it on your phone. Well, why don't you have a smartphone? So that's what it is.
That's what was causing problems with, older Americans getting their vaccine, is that you had to sign up for it online, and some of them didn't have computer access.
Oh.
Well, that was the whole purpose of why the vaccine center was set up originally, that it was for people who don't have access to computers or aren't too savvy with their phones or whatever, so they could call in. But now, it seems people are just calling to find out what hours they're open and what vaccines they have, because now everything's walk-in at any way you want. The center is also, so.
Yeah, it's just so crazy to me, because I remember, like, in March when I'm freaking out trying to get this.
Right.
Yeah.
And now there's people just blowing it off for no reason.
Yeah. And it's like, you just walk in on a Tuesday and you're vaccinated. and I'm like begging people to get a vaccine.
That's
what a few months will do.
Yeah, right?
Now see what happens in the next few months. Hopefully, maybe they will only offer one vaccine going forward. Maybe they won't do two vaccines.
I said that when we were together. It's like, yeah, I got the Johnson & Johnson. I got the one shot. I really wish that they would have thought about, and I know at the time it was just get these vaccines into people, a couple months ago. But if they thought about it, like, the Johnson & Johnson is a perfect vaccine for populations where transportation is a problem, or, technology is a problem, so that they don't have to worry about taking off another day of work or something like that. I could have gotten the two shot. That's fine. I would have been fine with that. I'm fine that I got the Johnson & Johnson, although it whomped me for 24 hours straight.
Yeah.
But it was a rough recovery. Oh, but there are different ways to have organized this. But I guess
they're talking about needing a booster shot already.
I had
from 6 months to a year after your initial dose that you should be getting a booster. So if it's 6 months, then that means, damn, I got mine in January. It's like, ooh,
right.
Now.
Again?
Yeah.
Time.
Wow. I mean, I'll do it again. I'll get a booster. If it means that I'm safe and my kids are safe, that's important to me. Yeah. But it was 24 hours of me, like, unable to human.
My butt pretty good. I had a good 2.5, almost 3 days of going to. I would rather that to have COVID. And I was talking to a friend of mine who had it in December, and he still had issues. Now he's in his 60s and he had some other problems, but he said it's still, he has problems breathing. He has,
what do you call that? That's like
long hauler. Yeah, they call them long haulers. Yeah, I think that's what scared me the most. Is
that is scary. Yeah,
is
a friend
recovering but never being quite right again.
Yeah.
A lot of people do have those, like, long lasting or forever symptoms, and that's a scary thing.
Yeah.
Hopefully there's light at the end of the tunnel. We're seeing a lot of improvement. Indeed. This Delta thing doesn't come in, put the rug out from under us and put us back at square one again. But we'll see. We'll see how responsible people are. And we'll see. It's hard to have faith in humanity these days, but.
Yeah, that's another, honestly, I've had people ask me, like, you're vaccinated, why are you still wearing a mask in the store? Don't you trust the vaccine? I'm like, I trust the vaccine. I trust myself. It's those people I don't trust.
Right.
Exactly.
Right.
Sad to say, but the last year and a half, the last 4 years has really shown me that we have a large population of truly selfish and entitled people. And as soon as you ask them to think about something other than their own interests, they start, you know, like wrapping themselves in the Constitution, like, like nobody's business.
None of them have ever read. None of them know. That most of them.
They're using memes that they got on the alt-right websites that they go to. And
the sad part
is how many of them are people that I know, you know, family and friends. And I had a student post, a former student, alumni, post something about anti-vaxxers for COVID. And he was like, I just don't get it. And I wrote to him, I was like, you would be appalled at how many students you graduated with who are in that camp. And he was like, yeah, I know. There's a kitty.
There she is.
Margo.
Just hanging. He likes to hang on my shoulder like that.
Sure,
like,
yeah, except for your little meatloaf there hanging on your shoulder, Sheila.
That's what he does.
I love that. My Velvet, my old cat, used to do that too. Just like lay on your shoulder. I love
it. And just see him wiping his gums on me. It was gross. I hate when he does that. I love him so much, but I wish I was an animal person. It would help a lot. It would help immensely if I was an animal person.
Truman, let me see if I can, but Truman, come here. Hey, Truman.
And happy boy over.
He would be right here. I'm sure he's sleeping. He's sleeping.
Yeah. I know, he came up from his walk.
He and Barry are not going to come out. Right.
He tried to be my friend and I was a little shy, but I'll give him a chance next time and I'll try not to have a heart attack.
Okay.
What else? I'm very annoyed that I didn't give him a petting.
What else is on our agenda tonight, Sheila?
Our agenda? Well, what are we doing for the summer? What's our summer simple pleasure type thing going on?
Well, I think we've got ours right here, but did you see him flying around the room? He got the zoomies.
Yes.
And he was up on the dresser there eating the plant, hiding in the window. And now he's zonked.
I love it. Yeah. Oh, he's so sweet.
But we're planning to, we have a pass to the pool. So we're going to do lots of pool days. Nice. We're going to start next week. Cool. And I've been looking at things to take the kids to. There's some outdoor plays and outdoor concerts and playgrounds and stuff just to get the kids out and experiencing things. I'm trying to keep them outside as much as possible. So I'm trying to find things that aren't indoors to do, but
Martha has a cool playground across from our house.
I do.
Yeah, yes, I'm definitely bringing the kids over to play at that playground.
There was a huge picnic over there this afternoon. It's so good. Last summer, it wasn't used. People just weren't going out, but it's so good this summer. And there was, I guess, a birthday party this afternoon. There were a lot of people there. And they just have such a good time. And it's never been, when we first moved here, people said, oh, you're going to hate living near that park. It'll be annoying and kids will be hanging out all night. They don't, you know, it's the park closes pretty much at sundown. People are supposed to clear out and they do. I'm sure their kids hang out over there and smoke late at night because my son certainly did. my kids did. It's great. I think my summer pleasure has been getting our patio together and getting the garden together and now having friends that I can go out and sit and enjoy it with instead of last summer when it was just the two of us because we didn't invite anybody to come in. And so that's been kind of my summer pleasure.
I don't have any plans. This is sad. I usually try to go up to Vermont to visit my brother. I'm going to try to plan that. But
some honey.
Yeah.
Get some
honey. Bob said hi, by the way.
Hi, Bob.
Hi.
Bob. Ooh, honey is delicious. Yes. It is delicious.
I have to shout out, my kids have been really into smoothies lately. And so I put his honey in the smoothies and they love it.
Oh,
so
awesome.
He gets the Weaver seal of approval.
It's delicious. Really so delicious.
So I'll be getting more.
Yum.
Oh, please do.
Yeah. He's coming down to Jersey, which is great. It's about a 2-hour drive for me. So okay. We're going and just hang out for overnight. Far away.
I don't have any summer plans either because I think we all know I really dislike summer. So I try not to make I try to remain inside as much as humanly possible, if at all possible.
Sheila's summer plan, get to fall.
Sheila's summer plan, enjoy all the inside AC I can until it gets normal out again.
Make sure the AC is working at all times.
Listen, if my AC breaks down, I'm going to a hotel because I don't heat. Or I'm sleeping in the car. We have a camping trip.
Nice. Not to derail, but you said something about AC and that triggered me. We had a babysitter today, so we went out to lunch and we went to Saucony Creek at Reading.
Oh wow.
Oh, nice. Nice.
At the Reading Railroad Station. It's on lovely. Franklin. It is so nice inside. They finished it inside so nice. We sat outside and ate, but it was awesome. So, and I love that there's a Saucony Creek in Reading now.
Yeah.
What's up?
Yeah. And the food is delicious. The menu is so good.
Good.
Yeah, it's really good.
My friend had the Brussels sprouts, and I, as a rule, I hate Brussels sprouts, but they were good.
I love sprouts. Now I need to try those.
They were so good. They were so good. So, and
we actually ordered from them and had it delivered during the COVID, during our COVID days when we were ordering out. Yeah.
That's awesome.
It was delicious. Yeah. Yeah. It was delicious.
I drive past it all the time, but I don't know. It was never had a reason to go in.
Yeah. And their patio is so nice. It's so nice. And as we were leaving, it looked like a band was setting up for like a live concert, like a live band tonight. Yeah, so they're really doing good things there, and
good.
Such a nice area. So I was, as I was enjoying it, I was like, ooh, when we start doing field trips again, this needs to be one of them.
Yeah.
We have a lot on our list for field trips. We should hopefully get on that one day.
Right.
We have a lot of places to visit.
We'll get there. Well,
you know, a lot of places, I've been to a few places recently. Right now, it's Pride Month, isn't it? A lot of businesses have their Pride flags out, especially in West Reading.
It's
all rainbowed.
It's lovely to see.
Well, speaking of rainbows, Rusty, where do you have your cool new sandals with you?
Oh, and they're downstairs.
Oh, no.
Oh,
Rusty got a pair of accidental rainbow sandals.
Right. I ordered a pair of sandals in purple because purple is my favorite color and I was all thrilled. And I opened the box and I'm looking saying, oh, they sent me the wrong thing. And I pulled them out and they're rainbow. I never ordered these.
It was a good mistake.
But still don't have purple sandals, but...
I mean,
but now, because I'd gotten it on a website, now I noticed that they're showing the rainbow ones. It's like, okay, somebody, you know, they're not just purple.
That's funny.
I love them. The picture you showed, I want a pair. They were so cool.
They were cool. I like those.
Yeah.
That was fun. Well, you know, I ordered... I don't know if you ever heard of Monster Cookies. It's a local cookie company. My friend Helen and her husband own it, but they make these ginormous cookies. Like, and when I say ginormous, they are massive. And they did a cookie for Pride Month with fruity pebbles and rainbow sprinkles, and it was just delicious. But a portion of the sale proceeds went to an
LGBTQ.
I'm not a good with my letters, but yeah. So I went to one of those organizations that do, you know, research and support that. So that was pretty cool.
That's awesome.
But a lot of those places that are using the rainbow theme during this month for their products are not necessarily doing anything to benefit the LGBTQ
so that's something to know.
Community, yeah. And so that's...
A lot of them are just doing it so that you think they support it and you support them.
Yeah.
Exactly.
There's a great, there's a guy that posts, Robert Reich. He served in the Obama administration. I forget where. But he posts, I follow him on Facebook. And he posted, where was it? It says, he's exceptional in what he posts. It says, in honor of Pride Month, countless corporations have adorned their social media pages with rainbow logos and lofty statements celebrating the LGBTQ plus community. But don't let their rainbow washing fool you. Behind the scenes, they're doling out the big bucks to anti-LGBTQ politicians. So he goes to name some examples. So take Wells Fargo, who touted their year-round commitment to the LGBTQ community. After donating $10,000 to Mitch McConnell's campaign while he was actively blocking the Equality Act, a bill that would enshrine civil rights protections for LGBTQ Americans.
That's my new employer.
What's another company?
Or Walmart.
They're sporting a
rainbow-themed Twitter logo this month after donating $10,000 to Joni Ernst, a Senate co-sponsor of a bill banning transgender youth from competing in student athletics. Quality human being there. The defense contractor Raytheon is hopping on the Pride bandwagon after donating $9,000 to GOP Senator John Cornyn, who spearheaded an effort to pass a constitutional amendment banning same-sex marriage. And the company also gave $8,500 to Senator Tom Cotton, who supports a slew of anti-LGBTQ laws and even said gay people shouldn't complain about discriminatory laws because they hang gay people in Iran. Tom Cotton said that, and he is a representative in this country.
All right.
So it's so funny because we talked about that and put it on our list, and then I saw the post from Robert Reich, and I was like, oh, I need to share that.
How very apt, yeah.
Yeah.
That's sad. So,
make sure that when you are supporting companies that are doing things for Pride Month, make sure that they are actually walking the walk.
Supporting, right.
Yeah. And and that leads me back to Shop Small, because they almost guarantee are supporting LGBTQ properly. So
right.
And West Red is so impressive that with all the
they're so inclusive, and I love that.
Yeah. I drove through there today and I was looking at all the flags, and I was just like, this is beautiful.
Yeah.
This is beautiful. Yeah.
It reminds me of in Philly, they call it the gayborhood, where they have like that, all the clubs are. I love it. And it reminds me of that because they have all the rainbows everywhere. And I think that's fantastic. So good. You know, they need that support because that life is hard. And it's not a choice. So support what you can.
Well, the football player who just came out this week. The more I think about it, the more I think how ridiculous that had to have been a news item. You know, it shouldn't be.
Why does it even matter?
I mean,
it's a big deal because, I mean,
I know, but
who knows how many other football players are closeted?
Well, I'm sure that, you know, he's not the only one. And I'm sure that some of those others may take the courage, but they shouldn't have to say anything. It shouldn't make, I mean,
world news.
I really don't care if that quarterback is gay or straight, unless I'm a cheerleader trying to date him. I mean, you know, I'm just not really interested in that. It doesn't make any difference.
It's sad. Yeah.
But it goes along the lines of representation matters. So, you know, it's the idea of I'm the first one to publicly say this.
Right.
Hopefully he will not be the last, but yeah, you're right. I look for the day when we can get to the point where
not even an issue.
You are who you are. And, yeah. You know, yeah. And yeah. We can accept everybody, but I'm proud of him. It was, it was an act of bravery, but, you know,
he's a Penn Stater, Nicole.
He is. But it's also like, you know, there have been, I don't know how to say it, but
yeah.
You know, I'm glad he's there, but he's standing on the shoulders of truly courageous people who have stood up and said, this is who I am, and damn the consequences. So, you know, I'm proud of him, but I'm more proud of the people that he's come after.
Oh, indeed.
Just saying.
I agree. You're right. Yeah. And that's going to be, you know, with everybody, you know, there's always somebody that paved the road.
The way.
Right.
Everybody has that. So that's a good thing that it continues on, because it's needed.
Track of time.
In fact, I actually texted Nicole at the beginning here because I forgot what time we started, but I did. I'm watching. I'm keeping an eye on things. We have a little bit of time, so we're good.
We have about 15.
I asked right on the air. I'm like, Nicole, what time are we doing? And then I thought I'd be stealthy.
It's going fast, though. I think we're down to like 10 minutes or so.
Yeah, we have about 10 minutes or
so. Wow.
So let's switch gears for a split second here. And speaking of consequences, Catholic Church. Are they trying to deny somebody communion?
Isn't that
president?
Yeah.
What are our thoughts on that?
Should I go on my eloquent rant?
Nicole's teeth are coming out.
Start us off, Nicole. You had that good thing you said the other night.
Yeah, that was
very eloquent.
So the Catholic Church. There are members of the leadership in the Catholic Church who want to deny President Biden communion because he supports abortion rights. He supports a woman's choice on her own body. And my response to that is, I'm sorry, Catholic Church, but when people enter your building, they are no longer politicians or teachers or doctors or lawyers or shop workers or custodians or whatever. They are children of God, and you are supposed to treat them as thus. They come in flawed and with sin, and the act of communion is admitting that we are flawed and we are with sin, but we accept Jesus and we accept the sacrifice that he made. That's the act of communion. So if you're going to now say that this person can no longer receive communion because he is separating church from state in his own profession, then you are now politicizing yourself, at which point you should no longer be tax exempt. Just saying. And I'm not okay with it at all.
Well, I have a different, I'm looking at it from a different point of view, but I absolutely agree with what you say. I just think of the hypocrisy of the American cardinals or bishops or whoever these people are, and what they turned away from for so many years. And I can speak personally as to how my life has been affected by that in my own family. And also knowing that the American bishops don't agree with the Vatican in this. It's not the Vatican, it's not the Pope who wants to have this happen. I just think it's absurd and hypocritical. And as a recovering Catholic, I say that it's unbelievable. It's just unbelievable that they have forgotten what they have been so guilty of. Every one of them every one of them knew priests who were doing things that were horrendous to children. And so if they are so concerned about the life of children, they sure weren't concerned about it for a very long time.
Yep, a child, you know, if your only concern is a child born and not a child fed, educated, raised well, and protected from predators, then you really have no right to be in this conversation at all. Yeah, and some of those cardinals, some of those leadership in the Catholic Church maybe aren't perpetrators, but they knew colleagues who were and helped to move them around to different parishes and keep it hidden. And so that, I'm sorry, you are just as guilty. You are just as guilty, and that is problematic. And yeah, I agree with you. I see it as hypocrisy too. And it is why I still identify as Catholic, but I will not step inside a Catholic church because it's the hypocrisy that bothers me. And I think that a lot of organized religion has moved so far away from what it should be.
Indeed.
And I'm not okay with it. So give the man communion, shut up, and just deal with it.
Right. Right. Yeah. Right.
And mic drop. I love it. No, I am in complete agreement with you on all fronts, because the church should not have that type of jurisdiction to deny somebody communion. Like, they give serial killers on death row communion. But you're gonna deny the president that? But I just don't get it. So
yeah,
we'll see how that plays out.
Yeah,
we just have a few more minutes here, but like,
oh my gosh.
Martha, you brought up a really good book that we were talking
about. I did. I have it right here.
You do? Let's see it.
Yes.
What? Okay, there it is.
It's called Cast. It's by Isabel Wilkerson, and I have to say that very often when I read nonfiction books, I will get halfway through and probably not read the rest of them. I can't put this down. It talks about our racial problems and our racial attitudes in this country and compares it to a caste system. Rather than saying we are a racist nation, she is saying we are a nation with a highly developed respected caste system that has been respected by the Nazis, actually, who based some of their patterning when they decided what they were going to do to eradicate their Jewish problem on some of the laws that our southern states had already passed to keep Black Americans in their place. It's a fascinating book, and if you have a cozy corner to curl up in this summer, I would urge every one of you to read it. It will give you a whole new way of looking at things. It won't make it any easier. It won't make it any better. You won't feel kinder about this, but it's a really excellent book. I urge you to read it. Even though it does have an Oprah Winfrey sticker on.
Oh, it's an Oprah book.
I love Oprah Winfrey, but I hate saying, oh, I'm reading this because Oprah suggested it.
I love Oprah. I would totally read it.
I read it because a friend of mine has been talking about it all summer, and I decided I had to find out what he was talking about.
There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, you know, Oprah gets some things right. She gets some
things wrong. Absolutely. I've loved every book of hers that I've read. But I've honestly gone as far as to cover the seal if I walk around with the book.
You don't want anyone to know it came from her?
Such a snob, yeah.
Oh my God, that's so funny. Okay. Well, is anyone else reading anything good?
I am. Hold on a second.
That is so loud. I don't know if you can hear him, but he is purring up.
He loves us.
I am reading this fun little book called Lessons from Plants. It's by a really wonderful author named Baronda Montgomery. I was driving home one day and they were interviewing her on NPR. And she's a botanist. She grew up in the inner city. She is a person of color. And her first introduction to plants was her mother, who had a whole room in their apartment just filled with plants. And so it sparked her love for it, and she became a botanist. And so her book, Lessons from Plants, is the, like, how plants create civil, you know, like the communities that plants create, and how we can learn from how they operate together. It's been really cool. And like, it, you know, it talks about a changing environment, a friend or foe. So it's it is a really fun little book, and I love like the size of it. It just makes me think of like sitting on a park bench in the summer and reading. But she is a really wonderful, fun writer. I love how she organizes her thoughts, and as a fellow plant person, like, she's totally on my wavelength. So I recommend this book as well.
Awesome. I love that. I'm not reading anything right now, but I intend to, because I just found a box. I'm finally cleaning out my closets and unpacking boxes. Every time I move, I don't unpack everything. there's always two or three boxes that I never get to unpack. So I'm unpacking them, and I found a bunch of books that I forgot I even had. So I'm going to get to reading one of these days.
Good for you.
Forgot I had them. It was awesome to find.
Wow, it's like getting all brand new ones.
Yeah. Nice treasure hunt. Are you reading anything right now, Rusty?
I am rereading, I don't know, Christine Feehan. Have you ever read any of her books?
No.
I love stories, and I just it's set on the north coast of California, and it's supernatural and magic and
fun.
It's great.
Nice. I know Rusty has a cool cozy corner to read in. Rusty has a nice library to read in.
A special place.
I love it. That was my favorite room in your whole house, I think, was
nice.
The library room.
Although I loved your kitchen too. Your kitchen was so cute.
The
whole house.
The kitchen's not made for us little people, Nicole. We would need like a step ladder.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I thought you were saying my little people couldn't come in. I would not bring my little people into
as little people as in you and me. I meant we are the little ones.
I could not bring Lizzie into that house. She would be like, I'm gonna take this and that. And I'd be like,
ah! Oh yeah, teddy bears everywhere. She'd be having a party.
That's true. So funny. That would be fun. Horrible.
I mean, I will bring her, but you will not like the results.
Teddy bears.
Yeah.
I think we are just about out of time. I think it is. Yeah, it's been about.
Wow. That went fast.
Yeah, that went fast, didn't it?
Always goes fast.
Talked about having a short list this time. And we still get through our whole list.
No, we almost did though. We almost made it. But we'll try again next month. So
yeah.
I'm glad that we were able to get together this month. Last month we didn't have a show because, you know, life got crazy, but here we are still kicking. So we will do it again next month on July 26th.
And now next month and then August we'll be in the studio. Is this correct?
Possibly.
Yeah, we think so.
We think so. BCT is moving, so we'll see where they're at when that comes around, and hopefully we'll be together again.
Right.
Yeah, and on that note, a continued thank you to BCTV for all that they do and letting us do this once a month.
Yes, they've been great.
Yeah.
Thank you for that. So we will see everybody next month on the 26th at 9 p.m.
Woo, everybody have a safe and fun Independence Day celebration.
Yes.
Right. And we'll check to see how much Rami has grown since.
I had to take a picture here. Aww. Let me look at this. They both tuckered out.
Oh, they're both sweet.
David passed out and Rami jumped up and was like sniffing him, and he's like, hey, why aren't you playing with me? And then he laid down and fell asleep with him. So I took a picture.
Found his sweetest things. Oh, sweet. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Hi, thanks for watching.